Wild winds have hit the state, downing power lines and trees and damaging homes. As Maggie Raworth discovered, some residents were left with a hefty clean-up bill.
A 20-metre-high tree crushed part of this Belgrave home. A smashed roof provided a startling wake-up call.
All of a sudden we hear this big bam and this big bugger of a tree comes down. If the tree was on the other side, yeah, I guess, you know, I wouldn't be here.
It's a similar story at Murrumbina. Resident Michael Sue shocked when this tree fell just centimetres from where he was sleeping.
There was a thunderous sound. I woke up to see the tree falling on top of my roof and onto my window.
In the past 24 hours, wild winds lashed Victoria.
It started yesterday. We saw the wind picking up and then overnight it really took another a leg up again and we saw some particularly damaging winds.
With gusts reaching 117 kilometres an hour, Mount William in the Grampians was hit the hardest. Winds at Mount Hotham were recorded at 107, while in and around the city they peaked between 60 and 90 kilometres an hour. Last week's heavy rainfall combined with recent gusts were a recipe for widespread damage. In the past 24 hours, SES received around 100 calls for help.
This large tree fell just metres from where I was standing, taking down these power lines and narrowly missing homes. My cameraman and I are now trapped here on Wright Avenue at Upway, waiting for emergency crews to remove the tree from the road.
It is a bit scary, but like I said, this is why we live up here, because it's so gorgeous.
The Bureau says we can now expect winds to ease. Maggie Raworth, Nine News.